In this video, we look at how to download and install Oracle SQL Developer on Windows system. Let's get started. So first we'll download Oracle SQL Developer. So for that, let's open our Chrome browser. And here in the search bar, search for SQL Developer download. So once you search for SQL Developer download, in the first search result, you will see this Oracle SQL Developer official website. So just click on it. So here in the next page, you will see this the SQL Developer download page, where I can see this version 20.4.1, which was built on February 22nd 2021, and here you can see the support for Windows 64-bit, Windows 32-bit, macOS, Linux and other platform. And we're gonna install on Windows 64-bit, so just click on this download. So in the next page, it will ask you to log in into Oracle account. So if you don't have Oracle account, so here you have this create account, so click on it. So in the next page, you have to fill up all this information, email address, password, country, all these details, and you can sign up for Oracle account. But I already have Oracle account, so let's close this and let's log in with my Oracle account. So once you sign in, it will automatically start download for you, which will take a while and will wait till the download is completed. So it looks like our SQL Developer is downloaded. So let's go to download folder. So here you can see the SQL Developer zip file. So let's extract it. So for that, let's right click on this and say extract here, extract file. And it will extract inside the SQL Developer 24.4.1 and say OK. So our SQL Developer zip file is unzip, and you can see this file folder is created. So the SQL Developer is a portable software, meaning you don't need to install, you can just simply run it. But it is advisable you copy the SQL Developer into your drive where the Windows is installed. So let's copy this and go to C drive and go to program files. And let's copy here and say continue. In case if you have this Windows user which does not have access to copy this file into C drive, you can place this SQL Developer on different drive and you can run it. So now our SQL Developer is copied. Now let's go inside this, and here you can see this exe file. So let's create the shortcuts for SQL Developer. So right click on this one, go to send to, and send to desktop. So here you can see the SQL Developer shortcut is created on desktop. So for opening the SQL Developer, so simply just double click on it. So this will launch as Oracle SQL Developer for you. Now say no. Say OK and let's maximize this. So it is loading this page. So here by default it has detected this Oracle which is installed on my system. So now let's connect to this Oracle database. So just you have to click on this, so which will create this connection for you. So let's enter the password and say OK. So I connected to my local database. So what happened, like it has detected this DNS entry, and from there it is allow me to connect to this Oracle account. So now let's create the new connection. So for that, right click on Oracle connection and say new connection. So here let's type the name. So I say local and the authentication default, enter the user and password will ask while connecting to database. So here I'm using localhost, so let it be localhost. Then port is default 1521. It's the same for my database, and for SID XE. So in your case, if probably you have to change this host name, port, and SID. And now let's test this connection. Let's put the password and say test. So it says successful and says save. So the connection is created. Now let's connect to this and enter the password. So I connected to local as well, which is the same database, but I created the different connection. So for this connection, we use this the basic method for connecting this Oracle connection, but you can use this TNS entry as well. So now let's create the TNS entry for this Oracle database. So let's go to this folder where my Oracle is installed. So I go to this Oracle exe, app, Oracle, product, then this one, then server, then network, and then admin. And here you can, that's TNS names.ora. So let's open this. So here you can see this already have this XE on my TNS ora. Let's copy this and let's paste somewhere here, and let's say XE, then say local, and let's put here this local host, and the port is 1521, the default, and the service name is XE. Let's save this. So now let's create this the Oracle connection using TNS. So right click on this one, say new connection, and give this XE local, and go with default XE password, then select this TNS. So once you select the TNS, here you can see this XE local, and let's test this. So it says success. Let's save and say connect and say XE. Okay, so I connected to the same database using this third connection. So here you can see this all three connections are active. And if you want to, you know, open this worksheet, so just here you have the SQL and you say XE local, you just click on it, it will open this new tab for you. So where you can write your query. So here let's write the query. So I say select staff from EMP, I have this EMP table, and select all. So here you have this triangle, a green triangle, so click on this one. So here you can see the result, the employee number, name, all these columns of my table. So now let's go to any of the database. And here you can see this the table views, indexes, packages, all this database object. So now let's expand this table. So here you have this EMP table. So if you double click on this table, so it will open this the table. In the first tab, you can see all this column of my tables. So if you go to the data, you can see the data, and then you have this model constraint. So in the constraint, what we have is, let's see, so we have this constraint, and if you go to the last one, the SQL, so which will give you this the create statement for your table. So you here you can say create table, then your schema name, then table name, all this the indexes as well. So if you want to disconnect from this database, so just right click on this one and say disconnect. So you are disconnected from this one. So if you want to delete this connection, so right click on this one and say delete and say yes. So your connection is deleted. Yeah, that's all for this Oracle SQL Developer installation process. Hope this video will help you to run the SQL Developer and create the connection for your Oracle database. And thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video.